morning. I'm at the Sentosa Golf Club in Singapore. It's Friday the 28th of April 2023. This is the LIV Golf Tournament, the Singapore leg. First day, day one of three. And the first time it's being held in Singapore for this LIV Golf series, which is a very new kind of golf series, professional golf, deep pockets, a lot of money on offer for players. Heading to the range now just to watch the players warm up. Time is just before 9 o'clock and the first tee time is at 10 o'clock. So I think players will generally start to warm up an hour ahead of their tee time. So it'll be a good time to try and head over, see how they do it, and watch some of the players that are super good at what they do. Some of the marquee players that I'm excited to watch are Phil Mickelson, former major champion. Actually, there's a lot of major champions. Henrik Stenson, Bryson DeChambeau, Brooks Koepka. Yeah, so a lot of these guys will be, hopefully, on the range in a couple of minutes when I get there. So the entrance to this tournament was kind of on the other side of the driving range, so we're having to walk up this cart path that skirts the driving range, which is on our left here. It's a little bit of a walk, but nothing better to start a nice day than good weather and a bit of some exercise. And a bit about the course. So Sentosa Golf Club has two golf courses. There's one called the Serapong, which is where the tournament's being held at, as well as the new Tanjong course, which earlier this year hosted another tournament called the HSBC World Champions for Ladies. That was excellent. I think the Serapong of the two has hosted more tournaments throughout Singapore's history. Both are very, very good, very challenging. I've had the good fortune of playing both courses before. Actually, with the Serapong course, I think the times that I've been there, it's been caught off due to the weather, so I actually haven't played all 18, but I did play the new Tanjong course more recently this year. Again, excellent conditions, super, I think one of the, definitely the top course in Singapore, and one of the top golf clubs in all of Asia. So excited to see how the professionals tackle this challenging layout, you know, with their length, with the accuracy off the tee, putting, short game obviously is super important at that level. And yeah, as we approach driving range, excited to also see how they go about warming up, because that's something as an amateur that, you know, I can definitely improve on and work on, and watching how they approach, you know, what they do methodically. Maybe there's a bit of some of that I can take inspiration from and improve my own golf game. Now we're just reaching to the end of the car path, as you can see. This is the top of the driving range, getting closer. And that's the clubhouse of Sentosa Golf Club in the distance. This is fantastic. If you live in Singapore, if you're thinking about joining a golf club in Singapore, better be prepared to fork out much more, at least, than what I'm used to back home for golf club memberships. Membership at this club will set you back Singapore dollars, $500,000, I think, in or thereabouts. So at least when I asked recently, maybe, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's close to $500,000 Singapore dollars. Not sure how that translates right now to US dollars, but it's a lot of money. What's unique about this format is that there are teams as opposed to golfers playing individually. Obviously, there is an individual prize, but all golfers, their scores add up to a team score. And looks like, even at the driving range, so you've got Henrik Stenson, former major champion, the Open Championship, Ian Poulter, part of this team called the Majestics. And over here, you've got Ironheads, Danny Lee, yeah, former really good Korean golfer. Oh, sorry, I think New Zealand, he represents New Zealand. Scott Vinson, not sure who he is. Kevin Na, all part of the Ironheads team. Let's see if we can catch some people warming up over there. Well, here we've got Patrick Perez walking up to his spot. Super cool. And I'm at the putting green now, so this is pretty active. You've got Open champion, sparking his ball. Bag of Richard Bland. Looks like there's a lot of LIV Golf branded vans waiting. I presume because it's a shotgun start, meaning that there's groups on every hole that start at the same time rather than just going off the same tee. Sorry, hole, like the first tee. Staggered, so these carts presumably would drive, so like 13, 3 would drive the players to those locations. Shotgun start will be at 10:16 or 10:15. Let's have a look at what other hospitality stuff is around here or what's the setup. So this is looks like a hospitality private viewing area over the driving range, which is only open to, yeah, like Club 54. So you have that hospitality level ticket and you're allowed to watch. I presume that's super expensive, so I won't be going there today. What else is around here? Obviously, I presume Sentosa members are able to use the clubhouse. That would be nice, hopefully, one day to do that. Let's see if I can go closer to the driving range.
At the end of the season, the top 24 players are locked for next year.
But for some, this really
weekend long. We're about 1 hour away from our shotgun start. Stay cool because we are rising the temperatures. We're getting hot here in Singapore.
Heating up, literally, it's getting pretty warm, but also a lot more players now here, so you can just, you know, counting from the right, Dustin Johnson, Patrick Reed, Patrick Perez, Kevin Na, Danny Lee, C1 Kim, Ian Poulter, yeah, it's a lot of people now. They're getting to their mid-irons, long-irons, about 45 minutes away from came off. Just driving off in the distance is Brooks Koepka. I think he's going down to the start of the golf course. So, walking back. Looks like the Aussies are still not out yet. This is Cameron Smith, Matt Jones, Mark Leishman. Yeah, it looks like they're either at the putting green or trying to delay their warm up as long as possible. So waiting for them. So I think I'm just gonna head down to check out the hospitality area closer to the start of the golf course, where all the, you know, if you're not a Sentosa member or VIP, then there's not much up here at the driving range that you can do. Some initial observations, I think, compared to other driving ranges elsewhere, you know, other golf tournaments, this is definitely a bit more noisy. I wouldn't say noise, like it's overbearing, but they have, as you can see, the speakers and stuff playing music, which is good. I guess it makes, you know, for a more lively atmosphere. I'm not sure how that is to players, you know. I guess the players that sign up here, they're in, they know what they're getting themselves in for. But I guess as a spectator, sometimes early in the morning, I'm not sure whether it's better to have more peaceful environment, you can actually like hear the sound of the players hitting the golf ball, for example. Right now, back there, I was standing a bit a ways back, couldn't really hear the sound of the golf ball, which is what I enjoy listening to. You know, the sound of my shots are so crap compared to what these guys can do. So that's what, you know, I'll be maybe next time, hopefully get closer, or I don't know. I'll need to go back to one of the more traditional tournaments to compare, but sometimes, yeah, just a bit more peace and quiet is good. Otherwise, excited to see what is down for the public, is offered to the public at closer to the first tee. We're going to the Serapong course. The slogan is golf, but louder. There's billboards lining the entrance tunnel. Yeah, I love the signage, love the branding that's around so far. So yeah, thumbs up. So this is one of the hospitality areas. I believe this is in front of the ninth green. We're heading to the fan zone, just down the road here. But already just looking, general observations on the condition of the golf course. Amazing, pristine, so good. Look at that. Especially in hot and humid Singapore, the upkeep of, you know, grass and greens and sand traps and just everything in general is requires, you know, a lot of time, a lot of money. So to get it in this condition is super impressive, but to be expected, of course. Yeah, excited to kind of see what's on offer at the fan zone. So I'm still heading from the entrance area to the fan zone. Just think, yeah, if you come out to the golf here, just be prepared to walk a little bit. Just gonna be walking for several minutes, and yeah, it's just a bit of ways from the entrance. So something to bear in mind, especially if you have a bit of difficulty walking. Just bring a lot of water, bring a lot of sunscreen. Yeah, just be prepared to walk a little bit, which is nice because at least it lets you see the course. So I'm walking down towards the, on my right, just behind the trees, is the first green. Coming up to the tee area, tee box for the ninth hole. So as you can see, the merchandise fan zone area is still towards this side of the golf course. So I think if I'm not wrong, it's been a while since I've played this golf course, but I think they've changed the routing for this particular day or this tournament. I don't recall the first hole being that, but I could be very wrong. Obviously I haven't played this course in ages, but yeah, it'd be interesting to see. You know, it's already quite hilly over there. Green complexes are nice. I heard on some interviews that this course is more like a mid-iron player's course, so the longer hitters can't exactly bomb it because it's quite tight, and so there's a risk of, you know, losing your ball in the trees and whatnot if you go offline. So the players have generally commented, at least this is what I was hearing in the news yesterday, to get your ball in the fairway, and then really from there it's about 200 meters in. Those types of shots that really will set the good players, or the player that will win, beyond the players that, yeah, kind of fall back down the pack. So that's the kind of shot that I actually struggle with myself. My longer irons, my 5-iron, 4-iron hybrids, I haven't really hit them. I've been hitting them crap, to be honest. So yeah, maybe something here will get that spark back. I used to be able to play semi-decently with those clubs. So hoping that, you know, by just watching, I'll improve, hopefully. And just behind me is the 15th green, 16th tee box, and this is where the fan village is. So car Polestar is the official vehicle, I presume. They've got signage there, fan village. Yeah, compared to most Singapore tournaments that I've been to, this is definitely much more well catered for. Big huge screen here, bean bags, merchandise there, which we'll take a look in a second. All these food trucks on the right. Got some pizza, salads, wraps, beer on tap as well. Information booth, mini golf just there. Players and caddies, this is your quite good. Driving range
and practice areas close in exactly 5 minutes. Good luck out there today. Enjoy the sights, the sounds.
Here we've got a fan experience, which is Kevin Na. He's famous for the walk-in putt at the Players' Championship at the 17th green in TPC Sawgrass a couple of years ago. So there's the master of the walk-in putt. How quick can you make this putt, walk it in and pull it out of the hole? I've got a timer up there as well.
You can come and try again later.
We've got the chipping net.
Thank you.
Failed. But that was good fun. I think the spot that you want to aim at is probably you want to roll your ball here. Kind of get it high enough to get the momentum to come back down. But hey, I'm not playing for millions of dollars, so it doesn't matter. Thank you. Let's see what other fan experiences we can find and have a go at them. Okay, so we just have to chip into any of the three buckets, right?
Yes.
Any of the three buckets.
I just did three, I think.
Yes. You can choose any. Yeah.
Just close, just on the right hand side. A little too powerful or too soft. That was all good fun. So yeah, I had a few fan experiences. Actually, not sure if you can see the video. Birdie Shack. Actually, as a treat to myself for my birthday, just bought myself one of the basic hospitality tickets. That's the entrance level hospitality ticket. Retails for around $300 Singapore. What I had to do was, you know, several months ago there were pre-ticket openings. You could place a deposit there, and then that would count towards a credit to having one of these tickets to these hospitality centers. The Birdie Shack, Champions Club, Gallery Club, and Club 54 at the very top. Club 54, I think, retails for around $1,300 Singapore dollars a day. This one is $300, as I said. But the thing is, you couldn't use your deposit towards the general grounds ticket, like the basic entry level ticket, which is $60. So I thought, okay, since I've already placed, you know, that deposit, $110 down, might as well use that to, yeah, go for the Birdie Shack. So we'll check that out in a bit. Just want to have a look at the merchandise tent and a bit more of the fan zone before we head there. So, it's nice and air conditioned in here in the merchandise tent. can see some merchandise here, high flyers, the different teams are set up. You've got some unique Singapore stuff as well. This one, Singapore sling head cover, that's pretty unique actually. How much is this? This is going for, I'm not sure how much, but some unique products here. I'll just have a look. It's quite unique. LIV Golf Singapore with the Merlion. These shirts range are selling for $55. You've got LIV branded Singapore shirts here. But I think my Birdie Shack ticket does come with a LIV branded item, so I'll save the wallet a little bit for now and wait to see what that is. Maybe it's a shirt, maybe it's a cap, I don't know. So let's make our way outside. Coming up to past the Birdie Shack, going up to the 13th tee box. Let's see if we can see any of the players here. Not yet, but 18th tee is not too far either, so. Some lion dance people here. Performance before the event starts.
We are now under 1 minute to our shotgun start.
We're under 1 minute until the start of the tournament.
Singapore, 30 seconds to go. This is Golf Ballad, and I'm going to need to hear you in just a few seconds.
And the players communicating because the tee box is so close, they're going to take turns hitting their tee shots. So one here, then tee shot over there.
If you're ready for day one, I need you to make some noise and count with me. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go, day one.
Smoke, so on the 18th fairway, so 13th. So I'm gonna keep it off. So there's a glass cell queuing. Thank you. group punishment. Two right-handed players, left to right, so it looks like they're a bit, just need to get a bit loosened up. I'll go to the Birdie Shack and check that out. Should be quite nice and just in time because it's a bit of rain coming down now as well. So I'm in the Birdie Shack now, just exchanged for this blue wristband, which identifies me as having this ticket. Let's have a quick walk around. Yeah, the entrance is over there, and then I come in to the left, there's a bar here. Each person has three drinks. There's no food here, you have to get that outside. So there's coffee here. Looks like there's going to be a DJ set up there later in the day. Quite nice decor. Let's go to the other side, and there's like seating along here. Facing the what looks to be a par 3, 17th hole. You can see there's a golfer right there, about to putt. Let's make our way to the other side. I like how it's like got ventilation, there's fans everywhere. It's not air conditioned, but it's cool enough. It's just more seating over here on this side. With some TVs and yeah, overall, really nice setup. So even though it's only 10 something in the morning, it's never too early for a beer. And for beers on tap, it looks like they have Lion Brewery, Island Lager, and Straits Pale. This is a local brew. So let's grab, maybe we'll start with the lager and progress to the pale ale. Can I trouble you for, are you serving beers on tap?
Oh yeah, beers on tap. You want to pay or the stack?
Could I, sorry?
Do you like to pay or just take your scan?
That's yeah.
How many beers?
Just one.
Just one?
Could I get the lager?
Lager? Lager, right.
Thank you. Thank you. Alright, cheers. Nice. Love that. One of the good benefits of having this access is that it's all undercover. As you can see now, it's just started to rain pretty heavily. Having this covered area, especially in a tropical environment, prone to rain, actually makes a huge difference. Outside, I'm not sure where I take shelter. Probably in the merchandise tent. Some members are probably taking shelter underneath some covered areas, but there's not much around the course. So bring an umbrella if you don't have access to any hospitality or covered areas, definitely in a tropical place like Singapore. So there was a bit of a delay for the rain, but play is resumed. So as you can see, Graham McDowell, the US Open champion. Okay, very good shot. Just so crisp here. That's what I need to do. Why can't I do that? Alright, let's have a walk around and see what other golfers we can find. Might get some food actually first. It's approaching midday, so it's a good time to just snack up a little bit and head back to the Birdie Shack, get the maybe a few more beers afterwards. But yeah, the rain seems to have cleared, which is good, and so it's bright and sunny. Not overly humid. I think for the players, conditions would be ideal right now. To attack the golf course when it's a bit wet, the balls are holding on the green, they're not running too much. So I think we can see some low scores today. So one thing to note, I just went to the Vato's stand. Wait time is 15 to 30 minutes, which I thought right now I'm not super hungry, so I think I can, but I don't want to wait that long to get a meal. So that's just one thing to note. It does take a while to cook, so you just be prepared to wait a little for your food. Otherwise, maybe I might check this Good Burger. Maybe it's a little bit faster. Just ordered about 15 minutes ago from Good Burger. Day is really nice, weather's hot. Heard some comments around saying it's pretty toasty, which it is. You can see like everyone around is trying to find some shade. In Singapore particularly, if they do organize it again, maybe just like it might cost some money, but just to have a bit more shade in the spectator area might be a good suggestion to have. It would also protect from the rain as well when it does come, you know, especially in the tropical areas. Yeah, just something to think about for next time. Even so, like if you're a volunteer, I don't think that is sheltered. Like say you're outdoors, if it rains then all the stands will get kind of quite wet. Now hopefully as the event gains in popularity there will be more attendees that will have a better justification for putting up, you know, bigger tarpaulin or something like that, tent for people to sit under. That will definitely attract more people to, you know, hang out for the day, right? Rather than like trying to find any makeshift shelter. So just small point, but otherwise it's super nice. Like really enjoying it. Can't beat a nice cold beer. This one is the Pale Ale. It's my second of the day. Excited to get back out and follow some of the other groups later in the afternoon. So I'm now on top of the locker room at the fan area. Just got my lunch after quite a long wait, but I don't blame the catering staff. I think they're all trying their best, but it just took a long time and they're getting a bit mixed up with all the orders. I think they're just a bit overwhelmed at the moment. As you can see, I can have a really nice view of the fan area. Yeah, just gonna tuck in, have a bit of lunch. Maybe I spent too long waiting for food rather than actually watching the actual golf. So I'm gonna quickly eat this, maybe get another drink, and then head out on the course. But I think definitely food, catering, experience needs to be a bit more polished next time. Especially in this kind of heat and humidity, people are gonna be thirsty, people are gonna be hungry. It just needs to be a bit more, just faster service. Either the existing caterers cut down the number of options that are available and just stick to one and just serve that so that they can just push it out, or just get like a one vendor that serves like different food and have that like on a buffet kind of style, so it's like super quick to get the throughput rather than have people wait. Like already in line I had probably seen three people cancel their orders. Like they bought it but then they demanded a refund on their credit card. So that kind of stuff, you know, when a burger costs $20, that's already $60 worth of refunds lost of business for the company. So just something to consider, maybe make the order system better. Like people order through their phones and then there's an alert that lets people know when their order is ready so they can come and collect it at the spots, rather than like having one wait staff like handle all the orders. There's so many paper slips flying around, there's going to be bound to be mistakes. For example, my order, I had to ask, and if I didn't ask I'd just be standing there for the longest time because they missed my order, they lost their paper slip for my particular order. So I had to effectively go back into the queue again. So just, you know, it's natural, we all make mistakes in our ordinary life, so there's no blame to be made. But it's just something, you know, as a way of, you know, constructive criticism, everyone wants to get better. So maybe this is just one aspect. Food and catering is obviously, when you attend an event, everyone's, yeah, like I said before, everyone's gonna get hungry, everyone's gonna get thirsty, so you wanna make that as like smooth and you know, the best possible experience possible. Standing at hole 15, just saw Dustin Johnson, Louis Oosthuizen, and Sebastian Munoz tee off. Pretty empty now, everyone's kind of following that group or going to another hole. In the distance, pretty ominous. Oh, that's I can hear a sound. I think that must be the lightning warning. So that must mean play is halted. And yeah, everyone must, I guess, go find some place to shelter. That's the first, actually. This is my first tournament where I've had an experience of lightning, a halt of play. So, not sure how long this is going to go for, but judging by the clouds in the distance, it's going to be a little bit of time for this storm to blow over.
The lightning warning actually remained in effect for most of the afternoon, so it was quite fortuitous to have seen most of the players in the morning. I ended up calling it a day and heading to the public shuttle bus, but not before seeing a bit of the entrance, the short game area, while there were less crowds, headed back for the afternoon.
Now getting on a public shuttle bus, which is provided complimentary to attendees, and just going back to the shopping center, which is fairly close by to Sentosa. But it's nice to get a free ride closer to a train station so I can get back home. Overall, highly recommended. Great first event, and we're doing it. Definitely support people coming here. Hopefully, get the support out, get the word out. Come and watch your favorite players, some of the best in the world. If you're in Singapore, it's right at your doorstep. So close, so easy to get to, convenient for a first event. Fantastic. Hope you enjoy that, and see you in the next video.